During college, I spent nearly a month in Spain with a dear friend of mine. I had studied the Spanish language, culture, and literature extensively throughout my schooling, and I was so excited to see the land of Don Quixote, El Burlador de Sevilla, and eat loads of paella. On our first day, we woke up early, still young enough to deny the effects of jet lag, and we began gallivanting about town and exploring the new landscape. I was having the time of my life, as the adventure was filled with exploration, laughter, and delightful dishes. And then, about noontime, we went back to our flat, and my friend told me that it was now time for a siesta. Now, I had heard of a siesta, of course, but seriously? Nap time? On our very first day? In the middle of the day, we were exploring. It was our time for adventure. This was a new landscape. There was so much to see. There was so much to discover. We did not have time for a nap. And in my most adult and my most mature way possible, I kind of threw a temper tantrum. I didn't really want to take a nap. I didn't want to miss out on the adventure. But like a father talking to a young child, my friend explained to me calmly that this was designated nap time, and I could stay up if I wanted to, but he was going to go to sleep. Now, I didn't really have anywhere to go. I didn't really have anything specific that I wanted to do, but I certainly didn't think that resting was going to be the best use of my time in this new, exciting landscape. I was antsy and I was seriously filled with FOMO. So, my solution? I stayed up all through siesta time. I read a book. I searched the internet. I waited anxiously for him to wake up and for us to continue our adventures. And soon enough, he did wake up and he was relaxed and he was refreshed and I was ready to bolt, filled with built-up excitement. Now, later that evening, I learned something. See, Spaniards take naps. They also don't go to sleep until very late at night. Some restaurants didn't even open for dinner until post 9 o'clock. It was common for us to stay up very, very late into the night. My enthusiasm for exploration began to wane as I became tired and exhausted. My napping friend grinned at me because he was refreshed and he was ready to go for a few more hours. I did stay up into the night, but then whenever we got back to the flat, I crashed from exhaustion. I learned my lesson, and the next day I partook in the siesta. And this story kind of reminds me of our current situation today. When COVID first put everyone into quarantine, I hit the gas rather than the brakes. I pivoted my platform and my message and my approach, and I explored this new landscape, and this has tremendously helped my business and has positioned me well for the future, but I also have to be intentional about recognizing this as a season with siestas. This new landscape might have days that are longer than usually expected, and we might not even get to eat dinner until post 9 o'clock. Embrace moments within this season as your siesta. Now, a time for rest is not an excuse to be lazy or to stop everything. It's an intentional time for rest, an intentional time to recharge, a designated siesta time. The Spanish Society of Primary Care Physicians confirms that siestas can help reduce stress, can help cardiovascular functions, can improve alertness and memory. Teams that are overworked and unrested are more apt for errors, and sleep can help feed creativity, to synthesize ideas, and to improve problem-solving abilities. In fact, this is a season that offers an opportunity for siesta. It's an opportunity for you to refresh and to recharge. And you don't have to sleep. You could stay up in defiance. I certainly did. But what I found is that others around me emerged into the night more energized, alert, and fresh than myself because they took advantage of the siesta while I stayed up in defiance. So take some time. Take some intentional time to refresh and to recharge. Take a couple of days. This last week, I took my Saturday and then Sunday, and I took that time to stay away from all work. I read a book. I watched a couple movies. I enjoyed my backyard. I enjoyed the company of my friends, of course, from social distancing. And I was intentional about my time to recharge. And this week, I found myself emerging into the week more refreshed, more ready to go. This is the time for us to embrace the concepts of a siesta and to refresh and recharge. So here's what I want you to do. Embrace nap time. When we emerge into society once again, emerge as a refreshed and an energized individual rather than a stressed out, tired kid that missed nap time.